Hey y'all, and welcome to Spare Room. I'm Karen Terry, and today we're going to talk about how to run an event in your RPG. When you're moderating a text-based roleplay group, running events is one of the duties that you'll be taking on. Now, depending on exactly how your mod team is set up, it might be something where one mod is responsible for running all of the events, or it might be a duty that's shared between different mods that are running the roleplay. Whatever works for you and your team is perfectly fine. And with that being said, let's get into some specifics. So what is an event in a play-by-post roleplay? It's anything that you're doing that affects majority of the characters. So if it affects only one or only a few of the characters or only affects one ship, then it's not an event. So as a mod, when you're setting up the events, you should always check yourself and say, is this something that majority of the characters in the roleplay can participate in? If they can, then it can be an event. So the structure and pacing of the roleplay is going to determine kind of where people are and what they're reading in the roleplay. So we've got one extreme where it's somebody that's reading every single thing that's posted in the roleplay. And then we've got the other extreme where there's going to be people that are reading only their threads and only the stuff that pertains directly to them. And exactly where someone falls on that spectrum is going to vary a lot, and it's going to vary a lot by how fast-paced your roleplay is. The faster paced, the more people that you're going to have that don't read things beyond their own threads. So the point of me saying that for this video is you can't expect everyone in your roleplay to be reading everything that's going on, even if you as a moderator are doing this. So that brings me to the first point that I want to make in regard to actually running the event. You as a moderator should be reading everything in the roleplay, and you're going to use this knowledge to help mine for events. Two characters planning for a wedding? You can have a wedding event. If a non-player character passes away, you could have a funeral event. Something crazy happening in town? Like, for example, I had this one roleplay where the town was like closed off, like no one could really get in or out effectively, and they had a beached whale wash up on shore on their beach, and they couldn't call anyone to come deal with it. That was an event. So events like this might be simpler or they might be more complex depending on what they are. So if we're talking about those simpler events, then generally how I'll set it up is with a plot drop. So what a plot drop is a moderator post that updates everyone on what's going on in that particular part of the role play. And it's up to the players whether they want to interact with it or not. And the reason why this is important is because remember, you've got a certain percentage of your players that aren't reading everything that goes on in the role play. So for example, we had that whale wash up on shore. It would be affecting the whole town because you're going to have the smell from that whale and everything coming into town. And if you're not reading everything that's going on in the role play, then your character might not be able to react to something they would know and notice was happening. So hence the plot drop. Another way that a lot of roleplay setup events that I want to just touch on real quick is they'll have everyone come online at the same time for a few hours and do like maybe a chat-based event where you're constantly posting and stuff like that, and that's the event. This works pretty well if you have everyone in the same time zone with similar schedules, but if you don't, or you have people that maybe have really different posting styles and typing speeds to where they can't really keep up with each other, then these events are not really a good idea. So I don't really recommend doing these kind of events, except if it works for a very specific role play where you have a small group that all has the same schedule and can all get together easily. So I'll give you kind of an example of what I'm talking about. I'm 32. And that's pretty old for YouTube, I know, and it's pretty old for role-playing, but most of my friends that I'm role-playing with are in the same boat. They're adults, they have spouses, they have kids, jobs, responsibilities. They can't really all get online and just sit for a few hours and role-play. So with that in mind, I would never run one of those type of events. So what do you do if your roleplay is more kind of like mine, where people have lots of different schedules and different commitments so they can't really sit all at the same time? This is where my method of sign-up events comes in. This method works especially well if you've got a type of event where you're pairing characters together for some reason. It also works really well if you've got an event that takes place maybe during a limited time. So the event lasts for a weekend or a week or something like that. So I'll give some examples so you guys can kind of understand what it is I'm talking about. So when I ran my Marauders era Harry Potter roleplay, we had events where Death Eaters would attack and order members would have to come in and kind of stop them in their attack. So in those situations, we were pairing up an order member with a Death Eater, and they were supposed to fight, and that was kind of how the event was structured. This would be done with a randomizer, but we want to make sure when we set this up that we pair up muses where we don't have the situation where maybe one Mun isn't interested in the event, or one Mun is too busy for the event, so we would have a sign-up period. So during that sign-up period, we would post the dates for the event, some details about it, a little teaser for it, but not really everything about the event. And then what we would do is give people some time to actually sign up for it. This would be maybe a few days or a week, depending on exactly how long the event was going to be. The longer the event, the longer the sign-up period. After that sign-up period, what we would do is take everyone that signed up and we would run the characters through a randomizer to get the pairs. Then what we would do is post the pairs and post all of the other information about the event that we didn't post before, and we would start encouraging people to plot for the event. Usually at this point, there would be like about a week where people had to post their starter buy to be able to participate in the event. So if you had a situation where neither you nor your partner posted the starter, then you guys missed out on the event. If we had like an issue where someone signed up and they really shouldn't have and they got paired off, then what we would do is take that third kind of extra character and throw them in with somebody else, and we'd do like a three-way thread for them. So this is the way I would structure any sort of battle event. So you have your sign-up period where people sign up, then you run everyone through a randomizer to pair them up, then you give them a chance to post their starters within a certain amount of time. Now, of course, once they post their starters, they can continue the thread for however long it takes until it ends. And this works really well for any sort of pairing type of event. So I used battles as an example, but this could be good for like a soulmate event or something like that as well. So the other reason to use signups for events is if we're talking about timed events. So what do I mean by timed events? I mean events that close at a certain time. So I'm going to give an example of spoof days for this. Spoof days is something that I do in some of my role plays where essentially everyone goes into a dream sequence and you get a chance to do like an alternate universe version of your character, or you get to do something where it doesn't really affect the role play as a whole. It's just like a fun little kind of like side thing that you can do to develop your character. So this is how the structure worked. There was a teaser and a post that went up on Sunday, and you would have from Sunday to Wednesday to sign up. On Wednesday, we would post the full information about the spoof day and what it was and any specifics. So the spoof day would be something like Pokemon or Western or superheroes. So sometimes there would be pairings. Sometimes there would be like, write a little bio for your character in this alternate universe. Whatever it was, essentially you would have from Wednesday to do that. And then what would happen is we would actually start the spoof day on the weekend. So from Friday to Sunday, you would have that block of time to post your starters for the event. And what we would do is after Sunday, you couldn't post any more starters, but you could continue the threads until the next spoof day started. And we would do these spoof days monthly. So we were closing them out to make sure that threads just didn't kind of go on forever and ever and ever. You only had a month to finish them. So this worked really well to ensure that those spoof day threads didn't sort of take over the canon of the role play, because they weren't canon to the role play. They were something extra. But it was still something really fun that we could do. You could do kind of different things with your character that you maybe didn't get an opportunity to do in canon, interact in different ways that you didn't always get to do. And it was still super fun and kept everyone energized, but it made sure that it didn't take over other events that were canon in the role play and the main story. So these are the ways that I structure events. It'll either be a plot drop where you can choose to participate or not, or it'll be a sign up where if you sign up, then you're kind of expected to participate. So with all of that in mind, let's next talk about events as a whole and coming up with them. So I gave my main tip already, and it's basically read everything in your role play and mind that for event ideas. So that's method number one. So my second method requires a little bit of planning. So when I first make a role play, generally what I'll do is plan out kind of the overall first 6 months of plot that I want to do for that role play. And yes, this requires some planning, and I have been hella burned by this. I've planned out 6 months worth of events and then had a role play just completely die on me like in month 2 or 3. So that does really suck when it happens, but it's worth it so that it takes a lot of the pressure off of you when you have those role plays last 6 months or a year or something like that. And remember that just because you planned something in one role play doesn't mean that it has to die with that role play. Reuse it in the next one. It doesn't have to waste. So the way I tend to organize my role plays is in seasons. So just like seasons of a TV show, but essentially what it is every 6 months, there's a new major arc.
of that role play.
And that's what most of the events are structured around. So why do I do it this way? Let's talk about what events are for and why we do events. Events are essentially there to keep your players energized and interested in the role play. The point of an event is to make your role play last. If it's all on your players to come up with everything and you're not inspiring them in any way, what you're going to find is that most people can't or won't keep up with that. They're simply not experienced enough or not skilled enough or not spending enough time thinking about the role play to be able to come up with stuff. So you as a moderator are expected to do this. This is part of your role in making the role play, is to spend more time on it than a regular player. So you should be thinking of these things to help make sure that your players are constantly inspired to be able to role play. So this means the goal of an event is to keep the role play fresh and exciting. So when you're crafting events, instead of thinking, are my players going to like this? Think, are my players going to be inspired by this? And it takes time and patience to build up a group that works together well and roleplays together well to really nail this. So I'm not going to pretend like it's something that there's a formula that you can follow and it works every time for every group. There's not. But what I can say is just like everything else with roleplay, if you're focused on the right goal and you're practicing and growing your skills, you will be able to do this too. So that's the basics of building events and setting them up and running them. What other kinds of events do you guys like to do? Do you have other tips that really work for you as far as running your events go? I am going to make a video, probably the very next video, to talk about some winter event ideas. So get some ideas generated for those of you that are running role plays and are needing to set up events within this month or the next couple of months. So stay tuned for that. And let me know down below what your event tips are. Remember to like if you like this video, comment down below with any questions that you have, subscribe for more videos, click that bell for notifications, all the links to my social media down in the doobly-doo. Thank you so much for watching and make it a great day.